Hello everyone, and welcome to the review of the EasyN dome camera. This is a full HD outdoor camera, and it also features pan, tilt and optical zoom technology. So it has a varifocal lens and motor, servo motor, that will move the lens, and you can zoom in, and the zoom factor is around 3 times. So this thing can see some details, and you can adjust that, which is very nice. It has a dual connectivity. It has wireless and wired connection. It comes with a support included. It has metal parts. It has infrared. It has infrared cut, and a lot of other things, which we are going to discuss as we take this out of the box. Of course, this camera can be connected and configured simply with a mobile phone, and it comes with a manual that guides us with the setup process, and it shows us how to configure it quickly and the application commands. We are going to take a look at that. And up here we have the power supply, which is a 12 volt 2 amp power brick, and let's take this out. Here is the wireless antenna, and we have this is a sealed connector type thing. You can run a wire through it, and with the aid of this compression silicone gasket here and this O-ring, this will get 100% watertight, and will prevent water from entering into the connector. So we'll see later where that goes. So this is the camera, and is there something else in the box remaining? It's the mounting hardware. So we get 3 screws and their fixing counterparts, and of course the metal holder. This thing is solid metal. Solid plate here, solid metal here. It holds the camera with screws. This one is held by screws, so you can see it's really a tough design and resistant design, because this must go outside, so it should handle not only the water but also the wind and so on. So moving on to the camera, here is the dome, a metal cover here. So this is all metal. Underneath this is some plastic, and we get a reflector type large infrared array. So these are infrared emitters. This is a photo cell for detecting light level and activating or disabling the lights, infrared light source. It has a big aperture lens, and it has this small sunscreen here, sun hood, which is very good. And somewhere inside you can take this apart and insert the micro SD card. So this camera comes with a micro SD card already included in its price. So it comes with a 16 gigabyte micro SD card already inserted, because the camera also has a built-in DVR system, so it can record locally all that is happening, and you can check that remotely. Of course, it also knows how to send warnings and other things like that. The antenna placement here is strange, because water will fall on it when it rains, but as you can see, it's fixed on a silicone O-ring, so that shouldn't be any kind of trouble. So the antenna will go in like that. Of course, if you want to use wireless, if you do not want to use wireless, you can use the provided cables. And talking about the cables, this is the camera interface here. So you have a power jack, a LAN connection jack, and a reset button switch, a remote button here, which is used to reset the camera if things go bad. And of course, this one has a cap which you can cover, so prevent water from entering inside. This one will be connected to the power supply, and you can use this thing here to cover the LAN cable. Of course, you can take all of these kind of cables and put them into a special box that is used on this type of camera. I made the connections there and they will be watertight. So let's power this on and see if it works and how we can set up it quickly from the mobile phone. And now I'm going to connect power and it will probably do some test movements. Yes, exactly what I was telling you. So it does a calibration test, it sees the range, and if it has a preset, it will go to that preset position. All right, so now it has stopped doing that. So I'm going to connect to the camera. I'm going to use the EasyN application, which is very easy to use and it works with most of their products. So I'm going to add another camera and I have a few options here. I have Wi-Fi, smart configuration, LAN search. Let me increase the brightness. So add the camera manually. I'm going to select Wi-Fi smart configuration. You may also encounter another problem, the camera may fail to connect. If that happens, use a wired cable connection for configuring the camera firstly. After you do that, then you will have a connection. I'm telling you all of this because these cameras will not always work the same. So you should do that. So now I should be able to connect to the camera. Yes, and I need to change the password, the default password. So the new password is set, and after setting up the password, the camera will reset again and the application will connect again. In case the app will not connect again, just close it and start it back on, because the application may try to connect with the old password. If you restart the application, it will connect with the new password and you will see that the camera will reset in that time. So if I click on the camera, now I have image from it. And hello, you can see my hand there. So I'm going to zoom in to the phone screen so you can see the details better. And I hope that you can see the details now. This is the main menu of the camera. Of course, you have here the main buttons that you need to use, such as the pan tilt functions. But what is the most important feature of this camera is the zoom option, and you get this plus minus F plus F minus. From here you can zoom in, zoom out, and focus the camera, because this is a varifocal lens. If you have ever used a varifocal lens camera, a classical one, you may know that that type of camera had two screws. One was for the zoom, the other was for focusing the lens. Well, this camera has also autofocus technology, so when you zoom in, you don't actually have to focus it manually. If you just zoom in by using the F plus button, it will zoom in, and when you stop zooming in after a period of time, it starts to automatically focus and makes the image sharp again, which is a very good feature. It will save you a lot of time and it will actually make it work like a zoom camera, not like a varifocal, because it will be cumbersome for you to zoom in and then just try to focus the camera using the buttons on the smartphone. So that would not be nice. So this is a very smart feature of this camera and a very good one. Of course, these are only the beginning of the features of this camera. This has a triple stream technology, so it can record full HD, standard definition, and smooth, which means very compressed file. So it can record full HD, it can transmit in HD quality or standard definition quality, or if you are on a very bad internet connection far far away from this camera, you can go to smooth, and that will make the image very fluid on your mobile phone, and should be easier to watch. Of course, you can also use the full HD stream, which is, as you can see here, really full HD, and this actually uses a full HD capable Sony image sensor, which should provide very good performance even in low light situations. Other features are of course taking a snapshot or starting video recording locally on your mobile phone. If you see something, you just hit the button and it will record that. Of course, you can listen or talk. I don't know if this has a microphone, let's test it. So, can you hear me? Hello? No, there is no sound because this is a waterproof camera, so it cannot have a speaker. But let's see, does it have a microphone? I'm just going to turn on my volume. No, it doesn't have sound recording because yet again it's waterproof, so that's not available. So let's see what else we get in the menu settings. We get this button here. This is the cruise mode, which is auto pan, auto tilt and stop, so you can put this on patrol. This one here says presets of the camera, so you can set a few positions and you can zoom in and orient the camera in a direction quickly without doing the controls each time. So those were the quick settings. And if I go here into the main settings, I have all the settings of the camera, so you can control the password, the image settings, contrast, brightness and so on. Event settings, this is for sending alerts, it can upload files, it can save video onto the internal SD card. You have this full-time record option, and if you turn this on, the camera will always record what happens, regardless if it moves or not. And you can set a record duration, this will split the video in smaller chunks of files. And what else we have? So you have settings for Wi-Fi. As you can see, Wi-Fi is none because currently it's working on the LAN cable. Time settings, you can format the SD, set the cruise mode, reboot the device, light frequency area to prevent flickering of the camera. So as you can see, you can set most of the settings just from the mobile phone app. And as you can see, the goodies do not end here. EasyN has a lot of tools, free tools on their website, and you can download them and use them, and they are very useful and they work also for the PC. So for instance, this is the IP search tool. You just run this program and it will tell you the IP of your camera and its port, so you can connect with any kind of web browser directly to the camera. A feature that is starting to be missed on some cameras that are sold nowadays. Some of the existing models only have the app control from a mobile phone, and they are missing the full settings that you can adjust from this kind of web server. And here you have a lot of features, for example, view the SD card settings, format it as FAT32 format. You can see the capacity, the used capacity and so on. A lot of things here to be set. So in system settings, you have the device image, you have time settings, the camera can connect directly to the internet and download and synchronize the time. You have different options here to update the firmware. On the networking, you have a lot of things. You can use dynamic name server, you can create your own streaming ports. It has ONVIF, so you can connect it to DVR and record streams there. In advanced settings, you have user management, you can have admin users and guests, all of them simultaneously. You can set schedule for time recording, timed recording, you have email alerts, FTP upload. You have different banks of settings, the settings for PTZ, motion detection, sensitivity, and you can set a window for that. You can link each motion detection with another action such as email, upload picture, or save the files to the micro SD card. And you can get alarms in a predefined schedule. And in video settings, of course, you have image settings for brightness, saturation, contrast, infrared, error cut threshold, so when the error cut mode is activated or not. And of course you have video parameters, and you can set three different profiles: a low profile, a medium profile, and main profile, which is full HD recording. Beside this detailed web server configuration, you also get a free multi-Windows application. This is a camera management system, or CMS, sometimes abbreviated. Here you can add as many cameras as you want, and this app will connect to all your EasyN cameras. So if you have, let's say, 10 cameras, you can see all of 10 cameras here, or even more. And not only you can control them from here, all the settings like pan, tilt, zoom, focus and zoom and so on. As you can see, I can control it from directly from this application. You also have access to the camera settings and different settings of the app. You can see the recorded sequences. You can search them here from this interface. You have an alarm messenger and so on, and I can click here on this and it will take me to actually the camera settings, the ones that were accessible on the mobile phone application. And here I can control yet again the alarm, the Wi-Fi, time settings, and different parameters for network, SD card, power, video quality, and so on. So as you can see, it's a comprehensive product. It has a lot of functionality. All of the advertised functions work, and they work as they should. And it comes with a lot of apps that also work, a thing that is no longer sadly found in most other existing cameras that are on the market right now. So this was my quick review of the EasyN Full HD dome camera. You can find more information about it in the video description below. You will get a link there and you can see a full data sheet, all the specifications there. I really like this camera. I really do, because it does all the things that an IP camera should do, including have a built-in web server that is missing from a lot of cameras. And I like the fact that it has autofocus, and you don't have to fiddle with manual focus, which would be highly unusable and a very bad feature. I must also add that I hopefully will install this soon and get some full HD footage from it, so you can see its daytime and nighttime performance, because definitely you are going to need to see some video samples also from this. And I hope to add those soon also, but that will be in another video part, because this one is getting too long and I need to install this. So until then, be sure to follow my next uploads and see you then. Bye-bye.